large-scale production in various configuration bioreactors. Like this is one bioreactor which is a 14-liter bioreactor which can be used for mass-scale propagation of cell culture. This is a pilot-scale bioreactor and it can be used for propagation of cells under controlled conditions. These are bioreactors which are specially designed for the purpose of growing hairy root culture. That is, hairy roots are basically tissues which are very fragile. So we need to design certain bioreactors which will not damage and can be used for mass scale propagation. Like a bubble column reactor in which air is bubbled from the bottom of the reactor, and this causes aeration as well as mixing of the medium, and this favors high mass production, biomass production. And another example is a nutrient mist bioreactor. A mist bioreactor, here the nutrient is sprinkled in the form of mist, and that is how large scale propagation of hairy roots is done. So for hairy roots, we also need to optimize the media that is to be given to the hairy root so that they produce maximum amount of our desired secondary metabolite. So these can be done by simple studies or can also be done by statistical studies. So here we have done statistical media optimization by platform design and RSM, and we found the optimal media for generation of artemisinin using hairy roots, and by this we found out that there is what is the optimal media for these hairy roots and artemisinin production. So this is the statistically modified media, and as compared to the media given in literature for growth like MS media, it gives higher biomass as well as artemisinin. It has modified nitrate ammonium ratio. A high nitrate to ammonium ratio favors artemisinin production, and low phosphate as compared to MS media, that also increases our secondary metabolite production. And GH3, which is a phytohormone, is known to enhance artemisinin. So all that we tested. Similarly, other systems like Azadirachta indica also have been studied in our lab, and like as compared to unoptimized media, the biomass you can see is enhanced from 4.9 gram per liter to 94.2 gram per liter. So using these studies, we can highly improve the production of secondary metabolites and medicines and various other products of high commercial value. So the production of secondary metabolites were enhanced through hairy root culture, and the production of artemisinin was also enhanced and found out to be high, 9.1 milligram per gram as compared to reported in literature. And several other yield improving strategies